Hi, I'm Beth Pearson from Vaddio Product Marketing. Try that again. Blah, blah, blah.
Who are you?
I am Beth Peterson.
Okay.
Hi, I'm Beth Peterson from Vaddio Product Marketing.
And I'm Stephanie Johnson, an applications engineer and training manager.
And today we are going to talk about the ZoomSHOT 30. So we have to first, before we jump into ZoomSHOT 30 training, we do need to say a fond farewell to the ZoomSHOT 20. It's had a good run the last few years. It's time for retirement because the new kid is on the block, you know, 30 times Zoom compared to 20. So goodbye. We loved you. The memories have been great.
Yeah, don't feel too bad for it because that looks like a really nice beach.
Yes, it's getting cold here in Minnesota. We're a little stir crazy.
Getting cold. It gets warm. It stays cold, in my opinion.
Yes. All right, we are going to jump into the overview. So we've got a 30 times power Zoom. You're going to see a lot of similarities between the 20 and the 30, and that's pretty much the biggest one.
And it's intentional.
Yes.
They are meant to be very similar with some improvements.
Yes, some improvements. It's got the 63-degree field of view, a 1080p 60 high-def video. It's got manual pan and tilt. This is not a PTZ camera. This is manual, so you kind of set it and forget it. And then also has the built-in extension system that you love. It connects with our legacy Quick Connect systems as well as directly to the AV Bridge Matrix Pro, which is another popular option for extending the camera.
Yes.
So where is the ZoomSHOT 30 used? And a better question is, where is it not used?
Underwater.
Underwater.
In space. In a volcano.
Yes. Good. Everywhere else? Put it there. Probably not a huddle space. We know those are getting really popular now, and this is a long throw camera, so don't put it there. But you can see from this list, you can put it darn near everywhere.
Yeah.
Okay. Steph, you're going to go over the tech spec.
I sure am.
Yes,
boy, howdy.
Here we go.
Okay. So like Beth was saying, it does get power from its Quick Connect. It is a 30 times optical zoom. This is a serially controlled camera. So, you know, whether you're connecting to Vaddio controllers or third-party systems, that's going to be over serial. It has a 63 degrees horizontal field of view, which I think is very nice. It's not, you know, super wide for, like Beth said, a huddle space, but it still gets you a nice shot if you're zoomed all the way out. If, say, this is in the back of a larger auditorium and you want to get a shot of the, you know, auditorium filled with people, and then, you know, conversely, zoom all the way into, like, a lectern or podium, that 63 degrees at the, you know, zoomed all the way out gets a lot of...
A big part of the stage.
Yes, yeah. Exactly. Native 1080p 60 block. It is invertible, so if you want to mount it all sorts of, you know, different ways, we've got a lot of mounting options available for it, and one of those is inverted. And then the thing that I think is very important is that it has a very similar light collection and color reproduction to the previous ZoomSHOT 20, which means if you have a system where you have ZoomSHOT 20s and you were thinking about adding more, the ZoomSHOT 30 is a fantastic drop-in replacement for the previous 20 systems. You're going to have this camera, you know, in the same spot that a 20 would have been, reproducing a very similar image, again, with the same field of view, and then the colors will be a lot easier to match than, say, if it was a wildly different.
Yeah, and if you're working with an existing consultant spec, this is a drop-in replacement.
Exactly.
So no problems there.
Another thing to note, so this is now our longest zoom point of view camera. We haven't had one that's been able to do the 30 yet. So, you know, put this even farther away than the previous ones.
And I love this image. It's just so, it's kind of like an ominous.
It does look like it's staring you down. Oh, you know what? No. You know what it looks like? It looks like the Eye of Sauron from Lord of the Rings. Well, on between the two things.
Yeah.
It just needs to be fire in the center.
Okay, guys. Remember that. ZoomSHOT 30. You'll never look at it the same. Okay.
So kind of giving a quick comparison as compared to the ZoomSHOT 20, you're going to see that a lot of this is similar. Really, the main difference of all of its key features is going to be the zoom range. It's going to be the exact same horizontal field of view that the 20 was. It's the same manual pan and tilt system. It can store up to 16 presets. Two of them are available from the IR remote that ships with the camera. Generally, people are doing, you know, one close shot, one far shot on those if they're just using the IR remote. And then serial control. So again, super fantastic drop-in replacement. Nothing wildly different. So this is available, sold in three different systems.
Yep.
These are the quick connects that we were talking about. All of them extend power to the camera, pull video from the camera, and do the bidirectional control communication up to 150 feet. We're able to do that with our point of view cameras because they do not have motors.
Yep.
And the features for the outputs are going to be kind of the big deciding factors between these three. For streaming between all of them, the Q-Mini does allow USB 2.0 streaming. The QDVI is not a streaming Quick Connect, so it doesn't have any. And then the Quick Connect USB, you get to pick from either that USB 2.0 or you can select IP streaming. That's an either or one.
Yeah, a lot of choices.
Mm-hmm. And then simultaneously, there's going to be some other outputs available on some of these. The Q-Mini, there are no other direct outputs. It only does USB 2.0 streaming. So if that's what you need, we have a sleek, simple package for that. The DVI, you have simultaneous DVI-I and component outputs.
Mm-hmm.
And then for the Quick Connect USB, you have simultaneous HDMI and component outputs that go at the same time as you're streaming, whether you've picked USB or IP. So if we're going to do a comparison of like a good, better, best, here they are lined up. Your Q-Mini is going to be your good, tiny package. Your QDVI is going to be a little bit more flexible. Mm-hmm. Your QUSB is going to be the thing that kind of, does the most out of all the systems available.
So we're going to jump into a practical demonstration here mm-hmm. of the ZoomSHOT 30. This is actual footage taken from our ZoomSHOT 30. It is zooming in. It is beautiful shot.
Yes.
Yes. There's the ZoomSHOT.
Dum-ba-da-bum-da.
Okay. Time for some design and applications.
Yes. So, if you've designed with the ZoomSHOT 20 or the original ZoomSHOT before, some of these are going to look pretty familiar. But for those of you that haven't, here are some design options. The camera does ship with a thin profile wall mount, but we do have a lot of other mounting options available if you'd like to get a little bit more fancy. Like I mentioned earlier, there's the inverted mounts. We do have, like I'm displaying here, the in-wall mount mm-hmm. that, partially recesses it, gives it a kind of a nice white powder-coated back box.
It's help you meet ADA compliance if mm-hmm. that's what you're needing for the space, is mm-hmm. it'll get it recessed into the wall.
Exactly. And then for our Quick Connects that offer the USB 2.0 outputs, if you need extension farther than the 150 feet that the Quick Connect provides you, we do also have USB 2.0 extenders that you can add to those. Now, line diagrams for how to connect these up. The first one I wanted to do was a multi-camera system. So here we have either a Quick Connect DVI system or a Quick Connect USB system. Both of them are feeding into the AV Bridge Matrix Mix. This is one of our controller switchers. It has HDMI video and serial control available. So just, the Quick Connects mount nearby it, and then you would run serial control RS-232 and then your video into the switcher. For something a little bit easier, we were talking earlier about the Matrix Pro. For this configuration, your Matrix Pro is your Quick Connect. It's extending your power, your video. Look at how simple that diagram
very
is.
Very easy.
It really is.
That's the best part of the Matrix Pro is that it does make for some very simple mm-hmm. installation.
And for this two-cable system, you can connect up to three ZoomSHOT 30s directly that way. And you could connect a fourth one up, but we only have an HDMI on the last input. So that would just, you would want a Quick Connect on that one. Let's say you're doing a single camera system. We've got the camera with a Quick Connect USB. You've got your simultaneous HDMI. Take that out to a monitor. You've got your USB or your IP streaming that can go to a cloud service or to a laptop to do recording, things like that. Mm-hmm. And then we have, in this diagram, third-party control from like a Crestron system. Now that can connect to the Quick Connect USB either over RS-232 or you can do network control with the Quick Connect USB because you're talking to it and then it translates that back up to serial to the camera.
Yep.
Another simple diagram, is maybe the simplest.
The easiest.
The Q-Mini, like I said, it's streamlined. It's got, the things that it does. Single cable out to the camera, bringing back power and video. We're taking that USB 2 to a laptop that's taking it out to a distribution system. And then if you would like, there's, you can connect third-party control or a Vaddio controller to the RS-232 on the back of the camera.
One of the simplest video setups because, you don't have any PTZ. It's mm-mm. just the camera sits there and you just let it go and let it run.
This is so easy for an installer to install.
Yeah.
Super quick, in and out, saves you some money.
So what is in the box?
What comes in the box is going to be your camera, your mount, your mounting hardware, your cute little remote that's got your two presets and things like that.
It's adorable, yes.
Yes. Your quick connect of choice, you're going to get your QUSB, your QMini, or your QDVI. Our USB quick connects ship with a USB cable to can make that connection. And then there's going to be the power supply to power the quick connect, which in turn powers the camera. We do also have this packed for the AV Bridge Matrix Pro. So that one just comes with the camera, the mount, and the remote so that it can connect directly to the AV Bridge Matrix Pro, which would then provide it its power, pull its video, and you know, have its control back and forth.
Yep, so any cameras that connect directly to the AV Bridge Matrix Pro on our price list and on the website will have AVBMP listed after the camera. So, you know, that's pretty easy. That's
it's super secret code for AV Bridge Matrix Pro.
Yes. Super secret, not so secret anymore. All right, so we're going to wrap this up by just going over why Vaddio. Why would you choose the Vaddio ZoomSHOT 30? Because Steph and I are likable people, and we would like to keep a job here, you know, selling more ZoomSHOT 30s. And they are, you know, they're made in Minnesota, so they're made right on the other side of this wall.
Yes.
If you didn't hear anyone, hopefully, during this recording. And another thing is that we have amazing technical support. So you've got folks like Steph, who you can call 11 by 5, so 5 days a week, 11 hours a day, you can get support people like Steph, and we have a full team here in the U.S. in Minnetonka, as well as...
Right over there.
Yeah, on the other side of the wall. And also we have teams located throughout the world supporting as well. So we have a great warranty as well for these cameras. We have the two-year parts and labor for maximum performance, and then we also have the advanced replacement, which is standard on all of our cameras. And then... finally, the art of easy. So it really couldn't get any simpler than this ZoomSHOT 30. It's had a great run, the ZoomSHOT 20, and we're just going to continue that with this new and improved version.
Yeah, connect a category cable and go.
And go. So thanks for watching this technical training, and I'll put the number and the email address for tech support down below, and happy selling. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.